Vedete che è questo? Se la mamma non è più in un'unica situazione, poi c'è il proprio, per esempio, che è un po' di vivere in una paese che è una volta. E però volte mi dice che non è un po' di tempo di vivere in una famiglia, ma non è una tante, ma però volte mi sono messo in un po' di vivere in una paese che è una volta, a un sacco di scuola, però volte che mi sono messo in un po' di vivere in una famiglia, ma poi mi sono messo in un Allora, se non c'è il progetto di vita, c'è il sogno di cui in faccia o di mantenere il bisogno come primo punto di fare. Se non è un mio responsabile di seguire a tutti i miei sistemi, c'è un altro che è il valore per mantenere il tutto. E se non è un mio direzione, a mio giudizio c'è un mio direzione che lo che fare in modo da sapere di seguire in sogno. Lo che sia, è quello che è la mia direzione a fare di collaborazione. E poi si diceva una famiglia in cui il frutto è trovare la tutta. La risposta è che la famiglia è un grazie, ma in cui si parla loro di fare un processo di tutto il caro. E non è un caro di noi che collabora, e non si viene di quella zona, è un grazie. A questo è un compito, che la vera comunità è la nostra parola di questo. Se questo è un tipo di rapporto, è un grazie, ma è un grazie. And I feel that even though that's the struggle until the point when you ask them to do something differently, they just think that people are going to hit the thing. So people want to put some back on it, but they need to make difficult to do anything different to each system. So the fear of collaborating and faith on a really radical fear that there is no simple or serious solution for the challenges we face today. Collaboration is used to implement our private benefit by raising the zero to achieve a predictive benefit. No further improved by raising the high and achieving an upgraded benefit. Some simple and logical tools that really have to achieve and require high skills and leadership. Third, our common history meeting is based on a series of so much to the highest of the populace. It's about a stupid meeting for the populace. We need to superpower of the ability to open the soul and to address the human environment we need. The political impact is criminalized under the highly adjustable model of respect in the situation. So rather than being a superwoman and trying to conquer the world, political impact is a structural approach to social and social ills. So service is the same for the world, not for this world. Collective impact is a framework to solve deeply issues and complex social problems. Again, based on an idea of regional, single, individual, program, agency, and government department that can solve the problems we face. So, true collective impact is a structured approach to collaboration. It falls upon different actors from communities, government, business, agencies to work together to develop their own agenda. In favor of a common agenda of peace within the family. It's kind of a little bit like that. So, to the leading figure in the popular space, having a blue guy on a birthday, he keeps the conquer of the world is made up of four companions, the four horsemen of the popular. So, in a similar way, the mission of Peter Dinkins is made up of five key positions. The John Carmen and Mark Kelman give us our five key elements that contribute to work of the peaceful collaboration. The first is having a team vision, so even when telling a child that I am satisfied and others in a team is living the same. So we are having a clear understanding of what the solution is and an agreement to our plan to interpret it. A key target is a centralized data collection, so you can see how you're going against our beautiful leaders effort. The point is really good. A joint planning option, so that you can mutually reinforce the activities. Open and continuous communication between trust and transparency, and the last one is a backbone organization, the staff visionary to the capital. So this last element, the best part of organization is most collective interest in the objective. We have a centralized infrastructure, known as the best part, the dedicated staff and developers to help the participating organizations, both in ships and acting alone to reach the intensity.
creating concrete problems among the multiple systems. But that those challenges are different if they are complex, we must say well defined. You just can't know what the answer is. Systems like the third prayer, which is why we have always put to invite people from very many solutions that maintain the third prayer. We want to put barriers and problems rather than recognizing us through a system that needs to change. An effective change is about meeting with the DNA of the system. It's about upstream instead of self. In the history universe, the world's coming for either would be rather a recent crime. Humans in DNA mutates to give them strange superpowers. The first story is to suffer for either. The human populace is overtaken by fear of the new superhumans, and governments struggle as the old order of the world is broken forever. Recent times have been disruptive impact on the world. The face of distance and hope of the world regards as a price for the things of the whole world. But the world has changed, and these changes cannot be undone. The role of the victim is to provide mutant leadership, to negotiate the past, and find a way for humankind and mutant time to thrive together. Okay, so what are we going to do with you? Well, I'm going to discuss after studying indigenous corporations. We also need to be confronted with our inner feelings and we expect anything that we try to hold them up. How do we listen to what they are becoming as we are in the making? So it's a PhD looking at the challenges of indigenous organizations in Aotearoa, in Hawaii, and in Alaska. I know that the indigenous community complained about corporate structures, so I did a study on organization design and structure. I had a structure in the hopes of creating a new technical solution. I thought the problems of our urban indigenous organizations were critical, so I looked to create a technical solution. What I found is that indigenous organizations and communities face adoption problems. We complain about Western corporate structures, which are a problem, but there are most deeper issues relating to the ability of indigenous communities to keep pace with change. The better the amount of resistance becomes, indigenous or not, the more resistant it becomes to change. People often refer to technological change, but often a better change in the community is a generation. The cultural renaissance in all these communities has created a younger generation of innovative leaders with strong cultural institutions. Indigenous organizations are very prepared to adapt to the growing cultural institutions of their younger community members who are increasingly becoming disillusioned. The biggest problem for these institutions is the place of change like structure. They need to adapt. They needed to be followers, they needed to change to fit the cultural expectations of the young people in their communities. What makes a Māori organization Māori? How do we be more culturally distinct when we keep borrowing from Ākara that we've been doing it? How do we grow our own leaders to think like us rather than like them? How do we raise our own families and cities to live away from the forest? How does our culture compete in a digital age with unknown and with our issues? These are the most important problems, not physical problems to be easily solved, but complex problems that could only be resolved through experimentation and learning as they rise in a few answers. Changes occurring now at a faster pace than ever before. If we need more than any help to navigate our path to achieving the future, then we need to be like users to be able to adapt. The only thing that the future we can guarantee is change. So we need to start preparing to be user leaders, to be leaders of change and not the victim leaders. So user leadership is the activity of mobilizing people to tackle the toughest problems and bring a predictable initiative to achieve change. Inflation is specifically about change that enables the society to thrive. Policies of inflation build on the past rather than traditions. Inflation is a crisis where our DNA is reconfigured to give the species the ability to thrive and move those in their changing environment. It's a style of DNA which is no longer useful, and new ones which are regulated DNA into new fundamentals. So the super new technology always takes the beast from the past into the future. In August last year, Christian reports the Corridor of children whose modern leaders need to move on. He's an individual with almost supernatural and cerebral powers. He's the equivalent of the leader that is in the future of the baby. Christian is a strong man who is suffering from a comfortable incumbency. He says now he's in victory in getting the mind of the country. The spirit of the greatest opportunity to appoint leaders to go comfortable from the position and call for them to sit down and make the way for the next generation. Now we're showing the point that also needs to recognize that youth leadership is about building upon the DNA of the kingdom of the world. The youth leadership is about throwing away all the efforts of all those who have been before us. The spirit will drive us to evolve, taking a beast of those who have been before us and reconsidering it to thrive in the future. Rather than throwing away our elders, what can we learn, what works, and what can we take forward when we become the leaders of tomorrow? The youth leadership is about taking what works, not throwing anything away. Another entity of youth leadership is experimentation. We can use it as projects and others we don't know the answer to. So we put our problems in place around where we don't know the answer and cannot predict. We actually do not have a magical power to see into the future. They cannot anticipate where they are in the corner, but they can trust it. We can use it as far as using it as a zone of risk. The new meaning of understanding and knowledge, new ways of looking can occur. You can't innovate from hand on the top. You have to get out of your proper zone into a space of danger. Addictive problems require learning and innovation. Leadership is an extreme need to have, as you need to change, we also need to be able to adhere to practice. So this can raise the hands of experimentation to what is called the danger room. The business broker wants to hone the recent abilities of its students to bring their capacity to handle the human challenge. The first phase is created an ultimate battle simulator. The idea of this is to push them beyond the comfort zone into an uncomfortable space, a learning space. So the victory is not only the future, but it can prepare for us and constantly avoid new tactics and ways of working together. Xavier School for Music is a place of experimentation and learning. It is a school for creating music leaders who can survive the turbulence of change and ensure the capacity for others to survive and thrive in a new world. And that's a good thing that we call deep search for each other, but the idea of being able to adapt means existing in a space outside of our comfort zone. And we find ways to constantly push ourselves and each other to meet us to innovate. The change and hope of you to evolve. We cannot accept systems change from a place of comfort. Change is uncomfortable and we have to grow our capacity to thrive. Transitioning to criticize modern leaders as being too comfortable in losing the reach. The future is teaching us as to adapt and to push beyond the frontiers and to grow in an unfamiliar position to start up new ways of understanding and being. Intention relies on diversity, and evolutionary biology makes the world of risk to mutation, sharing greater diversity, makes it relies on diversity. The provision of our own vehicle is much desire of increasing the odds of some members of the species to survive in an abundant ecosystem. The risk team also rely on diversity. They cannot predict what challenges they will face, so they form diverse teams from cases ability to survive whatever they may encounter. This diversity of skills gives you diversity of options. I don't have a big team, a big muscle here, but only option is to be like the whole team, I'm not hearing of lying and doing sin to give them a gift of others. But from out of the power of enemy with sheep, freezing and ice, sparkling and rotten, and we sacrifice power to put them to sleep. The brothers of our worshiping of the sheep, the brothers of our worshiping of the offspring to go to British Bible. And now we find the suffering of serious social change history that modern years have with the true and current irony of the conscience. Our history of the Christians forces us to spend more time hoping and thinking to ensure our solutions are not superficial. If we invest in humans that we do not think a lot, we seem to go for the first solution, the most superficial solution. The spirit of mutual leadership of this salvation, making the others and don't contact us, pushes us to see things in new ways. It gives us options to know the soul of the soul. The working to see that requires asking, thinking, and thinking, collaborative intelligence. Using language, value, and intellectual vibration, which is our investment of our own strength and value the strength of others. It is truly a much more powerful movement in the world, but it's the level of intelligence that is the icecraft, it keeps it driving. I remember that it's very much time to heal, and the same thing as collaboration, when the individual spirits are working in harmony, but they are attuned to their true power. And that's the deep thing that really God means to form standards and find the value of spirit. States that have never been treated in us, but if you're serious about social problems, then you need to achieve both diversity and collaborative intelligence through to the field. We need diverse perspectives to put our solutions beyond the mind and to be territories. We also need to know how to harness the diverse strengths of others. Diversity ensures that we always be more to do than we can do with the past. Another thing that seems to be facing a future of being facing is time. A species has not evolved overnight. It approaches from a tour of over thousands, if not millions, of years. The future is not known to be for a thousand million population and hundreds of years of lifetime. So what does he do? He goes to school. He creates the culture by listening and learning to grow the next generation of human beings. He creates the generation of new leaders to consist of partners from listening to the mutual problem to co-planning an alternative future where reason, science, and human power strive to do it. We now take one generation to lead the leaders and three generations to do it well. Although the rapport to the natural life career might not be achieved within my lifetime, using leadership is about addressing change, but it's also about a system that change doesn't appear overnight. The system in question isn't just about addressing the new environment, it's about growing a potential to change so we can survive no matter what it is. You know, some of our young leaders from the Tour Culture Design with the Farmer Club, and the system is a human being, and I know the Farmer and Huffer is a being of human quality. And I'm proud of the Dharma Huffington to lead. The reason leadership we have is putting in some of our courses like saving our language and tax innovation is still key. I used to go and work in the West Virginia when I was a long time ago, and I just got put in about 16, 20 years ago. I hope to tell you that. But my own mindset now is to support the growth of the brain and need to overpower our health to create the conditions for them to win and for them to thrive. Our role as non-need is to prepare the way for our young people to navigate the challenges of tomorrow. It means using our power that we have today to create the conditions for them to meet us and use the knowledge to the power of tomorrow. We know that there are no easy solutions for treating complex problems. When we face some questions, we often try to avoid the focusing on our children and not demand the best of the system that our life is under. We focus on isolated interests rather than collective interests. For us to progress in a fast-changing world, we need to learn to do that and cultivate system thinking and system leadership. the people is constantly touching the gap between living and reality through the use of the machine for cerebral. The procedure book is machine to amplify the data and embodies the reminders of the future to be over mankind and humankind as one all encompassing system. The machine cerebral is designed to strip out of the system as a whole to provide systems leadership. Advancing the progress of the whole rather than serving the interests of only one single part. System leadership is not a new concept for man. Final order is a perfect example of the system thinking and judging about. We understand that our being is not tied to one aspect of an ecosystem, but is entangled with multiple systems within our environment. Final order is a compelling vision for an achievement of our future, a vision of hope. That is focused on the entirety of the system and how it can support climate water globally. So maybe I can tell you in Ethiopia, I've worked for a cerebral chart machine for 19 days out of the critical criticism really about climate water comes from those intrigued in their own perspective. People can't see the system because they are seeing it entirely. It's a lot easier to see the system and not being a victim of it. We were taking time to our needs and needs. Our communities are too long, so long being victims of change that it will require strong leadership that we hope to be mastered with it. The treaty still in place is to promote a leadership focus on wealth and dreams. It's in our power, our dreams to become lonely. Strongly, we have to beat opposition around and beat over the long and sheer force of will. This is in a criticism, it's just an observation. If you're not trying to retain some of the old tough jobs in good, we probably need to move on the street of our time and still be waiting on the team. But if you move into a new life of collaboration, our leaders will need adaptive skills to deal with the aggressive nature of the problems we face. We will need collaborators more than rulers. We need leaders who can bring diverse perspectives together and find common ground. The final order to appear, we need to live together. Collaborative action means collaborative leadership. Collaborative leadership means collaborative intelligence. The need for leadership I've been talking about is about moving leadership from the manual to the truth of the new self. It's about removing the pain that is not coming to heal, but master. Showing our ability to adapt and showing our ability to thrive. No matter what challenge we may encounter in the future. If we seek to work together, then we must also work to find new ways of living, level the ways of living to ensure that we become the master of the future challenge and never again the victim of it. So, in closing, I think my way needs to be more like the victim. By doing, we need to be the first of change makers with respect as a group of self study. We live in a world where the system often doesn't work for our people. Our role then is to change the system. We must work on each other's strengths and use them to provide our best. Most of all, we need to remember that it's only when we work together that we can achieve our true power. It's only through collective action that we can give a hope to achieve collective people. I'm going to go to the next one.